Hello children. In our last lesson, we learned that Omana and her family were traveling from Ahmedabad to Kozhikode. Since Omana's friend Radha was unable to join her in the journey, Omana starts writing a diary to let Radha know all about the journey. They boarded the train on 16th May from Ahmedabad, and after a night's journey passing through Gujarat and Maharashtra, on the 17th, their train is now passing through Goa. Let's read her diary and find out all that she saw today. So shall we begin? Chapter 7, From the Window. 17th May. It is morning now. Last night, I went to sleep early. It was too dark to see anything outside. When the train stopped early this morning, I woke up. It was Madgaon. That was written on the board at the platform. Appa said that we were going through the state of Goa. We got off at the station and had some hot tea and filled our water bottles. The train started again. I find it difficult to describe the scene outside. It is so beautiful. It is green everywhere. Fields with red soil and green crops, hills covered with trees. So children, we saw that Omana and her family left from Ahmedabad on 16th of May in the morning at around 11:30. All right? The train passed through Gujarat, Maharashtra, and on 17th morning, it reached Goa. They reached a station called Madgaon, where the train stopped for a little while. They could get down, have tea, fill up their bottles, and the train started again. From the window, Omana saw very beautiful scenery outside. It was green all around. There were lots of fields, hills, there was a lot of water also. And she really enjoyed the scenery outside. Page 54. Sometimes I can see small ponds and far away behind the hills more water. I can't make out if it is a river or the sea. The air is cooler and not so dry as in Ahmedabad. Now before we move on, children, I would like you to know about Goa. Goa is a small little state at the southern tip of Maharashtra. As you see, Goa has the Arabian Sea to the west, and so many rivers flow through Goa to reach the Arabian Sea. That is why she saw a lot of small ponds and rivers while crossing Goa. That is why also it is not so dry, because it is close to the sea. So when a place is close to the sea, it is humid but not dry. Okay? Let's read on. The train passed a level crossing. People are waiting on both the sides of the crossing for the train to pass. There are buses full of people, cars, trucks, auto rickshaws, cycles, motorcycles, scooters, and even tongas and bullock carts with people and goods in them. Some people do not switch off the engines of their vehicle even while waiting at the level crossing. There is a lot of smoke and noise. I see some people going under the bars of the level crossing. How dangerous this is! At times, our train crosses another train. Unni and I tried to count the carriages in one such train. But both the trains were going so fast. We always got confused. Children, do you know what a level crossing is? A level crossing is where a road crosses a railway line. There are barriers on either sides of the track. When a train is about to pass, the barriers come down in order to stop the vehicles from crossing. Once the train has passed, the barriers go up again and the vehicles can cross the tracks. So Omana's train also passed a level crossing. Through the window, she saw that people were waiting on either side. There were many vehicles. There were trucks, buses, cars, scooters, bikes, even bullock carts and tongas. He saw that there was so much noise there. Why? Because the people were not ready to switch off their vehicles. That is why there was a lot of smoke and also a lot of noise. Okay? She also saw some people going under the bars of the level crossing. They were in a hurry to cross. They wanted to cross the tracks as soon as the train moved past. But this is very risky and she found it very dangerous. Now, children, let us read the questions and try to find the answers. What was the difference in the scene that Omana saw from the train on the first day and on the second day? Now, as you know, on the first day, her train was traveling through Gujarat and Maharashtra. On the second day, it reached Goa. Now, there is a lot of difference in the geography of these two areas. There are different landforms, okay, different weather in both the regions. Goa is very close to the sea, so there is always a lot of greenery there. Okay, but when the train passed through Gujarat, she found brown fields there. All right, so Gujarat was still waiting for the rains to come. That is why the fields were so brown. Okay, so because these two states are so different from each other, that is why she saw a lot of difference, a lot of changes in what she saw from the window. All right. Let's read the next question. Omana saw many kinds of vehicles at the level crossing. Which of them run on diesel or petrol? So she saw many vehicles. Okay, she saw cars, trucks, auto rickshaws, cycles, motorcycles, scooters, tongas, bullock carts. So can you tell me which of these run on petrol or diesel? Yes. So the cars, trucks, rickshaws, cycles, motorcycles, scooters, buses, all these use petrol or diesel as the fuel. Whereas bullock carts and tongas don't use petrol or diesel as fuel. Okay, so you need to write that down here. Let us read the next question. Why was there so much smoke and noise from the vehicles at the level crossing? There was so much smoke and noise from the vehicles at the level crossing because people had not switched off the engines of their vehicles. What can we do to reduce the noise of the vehicle and save petrol and diesel? Discuss. So, children, what do you think should be done? Yes, whenever you are waiting at a level crossing or even at the traffic signals, it is best to switch off the engines of the vehicle. This way, we will reduce both noise pollution and air pollution and also save petrol and diesel. All right? Sometimes people cross the tracks even when the crossing is closed. What do you feel about this? Children, have a look at these two pictures first. In the first picture, you can see a boy running and crossing the tracks, and there is a train coming from behind. In the second picture, a man is trying to cross the level crossing from under the bars. Both of them are very risky. Okay? Now, we all know that it is extremely dangerous to cross tracks, and especially at the level crossings. When you're crossing, the driver is unable to see you from a distance. And if he's not able to stop the train in time, then there could be a risk of losing life or of being injured very badly. Okay? This will only give rise to injuries. There is no problem in waiting for 5 minutes, is there? Life is more precious. So we should not make the mistake, we should not make such silly mistakes of crossing the railway crossing, especially when the bars are down. Okay. Moving on to page number 55. Later, I was sitting near the window with my eyes closed. Suddenly, the sound of the moving train changed. Good, good, good. I opened my eyes. And guess what I saw? Our train was crossing a very big river on a very long bridge. As it was crossing the bridge, it sounded very different. The wheels rattled as there was no ground, only the tracks and the water down below. When I first looked down, I felt giddy. It was really quite scary. The river down below was full of water and had some boats. I could also see some fishermen on the banks. I waved at them, but I did not know if they could see me. Alongside our bridge, there was another bridge for buses and cars. This was built differently from ours. I think going over our bridge was more adventurous. So in about an hour after leaving Madgaon, their train is now crossing a river over a very long bridge. When the train moves over a bridge, the sound is very different because there is no land under it. Okay, there are only the tracks and then you can see the water below. Now this bridge that they were crossing was the Zuari Bridge. This is one of the longest bridges in the railway and it is the longest in the Konkan Railway. This bridge is over the Zuari River. It is about 1.3 kilometers long. There is also a road bridge running adjacent to it. Look at the aerial view of the bridges. Don't they look amazing? Now let us look at the questions on page number 56. Have you seen any bridges? Where? Now children, we see bridges over rivers, over parts of the sea, over other roads, or even over railway tracks. Okay? So if you have seen any bridges, you can write down here where you have seen the bridge. All right? The second question, have you ever crossed a bridge? Where? Now this also you can write according to your own experience. All right? What was the bridge built over? So was it built over a river or sea or road or a railway track? You can write that down here. What did you see below the bridge? So if it was over a river, you would have seen water. If it was a flyover that was built over another road, you would have seen vehicles and people. If it was over a railway track, you would have seen the tracks or the trains. So you can write that down here. Find out why bridges are made. So you can write that down here. Okay? Find out and let me know. All right, children? So that's it for now today. Tomorrow we will be continuing with the next part of this lesson. So till then, stay safe, stay healthy. Good day, children.